Dear students, I am Sankar, working as a physics faculty in Target English Medium School. Today, in this part of video, I would like to teach the another chapter from our physics subject in 9th standard level. The chapter name is Gravitation. In our previous videos, we clearly discussing about what is the motion and what are the concepts involved in that, and the second chapter name is Laws of Motion. Okay, the two chapters we successfully discussed, and we enter into the another chapter. The chapter name is Gravitation. And most of the students, you have some idea is there about the gravitation, but I will give a little bit idea to you, and after that go to the further topics in this chapter. So, what is the gravitation? It is nothing but the attraction force between the two heavenly bodies is called gravitational force. Listen very carefully. The attractional force between the any two heavenly bodies is called gravitational force. It is nothing but the attraction force between the sun and the earth. The attraction force between the earth and the moon, the attraction force between the sun and the Jupiter, the attraction force between the earth and Mars, like this one in our solar system. So that's why if you can consider the any two heavenly bodies, the attraction force between the two bodies, we are called gravitational force. Gravitational force is a attractive force only, it is not a repulsive force. It is very important for the purpose. Gravitational force is a attractive force only, but not a repulsive force. Because of, we know that if a body is released from certain height, okay, it will be fall onto the ground. If a body is projected vertically upward, below the escape velocity, the body is again returned to the ground. So, not okay, you can take the any bodies, we perform the either releasing from certain height or either projected vertically upward below the escape velocity, we are observing that all the bodies are reaches to the surface of the earth. It's nothing but, so earth is only attracts the bodies, it is not ripple. If the earth is having the ripple, some of the objects will be not fall on earth, they will be go to the higher altitudes only. But it is not possible. Why? Because of means earth will be have only attractional force. Not only the earth, the gravitational force having any body, that body will be having only attractive force. Now in this chapter, our main topic we discuss in this time, the first thing is uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. So what is the uniform circular motion that is we discuss in this time? What is the necessity to discuss the uniform circular motion means? So gravitation is nothing but mostly we discussed our solar system, discussing about our solar system. In our solar system, sun is the center and the eight planets are revolving around the sun in a particular orbit. The motion of the planet around the sun is a uniform circular motion. That's right. So discuss about this one. How to define uniform circular motion is nothing but means, okay, if a body moves in a circular path, if a body moves in a circular path with a constant speed, that motion we are called uniform circular motion. Listen very carefully. If a body moves in a circular path with a constant speed, then the motion of a body we say to be, or the body is in which type of motion? Uniform circular motion. In a uniform circular motion, so I clearly explained in the chapter of motion, okay, when a body is moved in the uniform circular motion, and that one physical quantity is constant and another one is the variable. Which is constant? Okay, speed of a body is constant. Is constant, and velocity is variable. So speed of a body is constant, velocity is variable or changes simply. So these two are we are observing that. So I will explain how it is possible. So it is a uniform circular path. You can say that it is the center. Oh, we can say that. So like this one we have considered. Here P is represented the position of a particle when it will be moved in the uniform circular path, either it is a clockwise or anti-clockwise. Okay. So O is the center of the circular path. What is the uniform motion? Or when you say the body is in uniform motion, if a body moves in a circular path with constant speed, that motion we are called uniform circular motion. So the body will start at this point, we can say the point A. Okay, so it will be moved, okay, in a circular path in the anti-clockwise direction. This is the clockwise, it is the anti-clockwise direction. We can say that the particle moves in the anti-clockwise direction. Anyway, in this one, at point P, okay, what is the speed of the particle? So the speed is a constant means, what is the meaning of that one? Speed is a scalar. Scalar means it has only magnitude, it's nothing but numerical value. That's why, okay, for example, here we can set the three points A, here the B, C and D. Okay, so at A, what is the speed of a body? For example, 40 kilometers, 40 meters per second. Like at B, 40 meters per second. At C, 40 meters per second. At D, 40 meters per second. It's nothing but, so if a body move in a uniform circular path, its speed is constant, means at every point the speed of the object is constant, is nothing but the magnitude or numerical value of the body is constant. So here, so speed is constant, that is we know that is constant. And the second one, velocity is changes or variable. How the velocity is changes? Mainly, speed means it is a scalar, we know that. Velocity means it is a vector. Scalar is nothing but it has only magnitude. Velocity means it has the both magnitude and direction. For example, the Earth is revolving around the Sun. The speed of the Earth around the Sun is 1.6, okay, 3 or 1.638 kilometers per hour. So it's nothing but nearly, for example, 1.65, we can say that the speed of the Earth is nearly, okay, equals to 1.65 kilometers per hour. That's why if the O is represented the position of the Sun and this P is nothing but, okay, position of the Earth when it is revolving around the Sun. Okay, if the Earth is at point A, what is the speed? 1.65 kilometers per hour. If the Earth is at the B point, 1.65 kilometers per hour. At the C and D also, the speed of the value is does not changes. Okay, but what is the velocity? Velocity is nothing but along with the speed, along with the magnitude, you must be considered the direction. That's right. To show in the direction, when a body is moving in a circular path, we draw a tangential line. With help of the tangential line only, we show the direction. That's right. At the point A, so what is the direction of, what is the velocity? Sorry, at point A, what is the speed of the earth? 1.65 kilometers per hour nearly. And what is the velocity? That's why we draw a tangential line. This is the tangential line. Tangential line is nothing but an imaginary straight line which is passing through the position of the particle. That line we are called tangential line. That's why according to the earth magnetic field, north, south, east, west. So speed is 1.65 nearly kilometers per hour and the velocity is equals to 1.65 kilometers per hour. Due, this is which direction? North. That's why due north. So difference is there or that? Okay, next, at point B, okay, what is the speed? At point B, speed is 1.65 kilometers per hour. At B, speed is equal. Velocity is equal, so means we draw a tangential line. Okay, it is the velocity vector. That's why this direction is towards which one? West. 1.65 kilometers per hour. Due west. At C, 1.65 due south. At D, 1.65 due west. That's why you are observing that the speed of the particle at A, B, C and D, okay, the speed is 1.65 kilometers per hour. That's why when a body moves in a uniform circular path, okay, the speed is constant. Because of when the speed is constant, that motion only we are called uniform circular motion. But velocity is not constant. Why velocity is not constant? Means velocity is a vector quantity. It's nothing but it has both magnitude and direction. But here we are observing that at A, B, C, D, the magnitude of the velocity is 1.5 kilometers per hour. But what it changes? Direction it changes. At A is north, at B is west, at C is south, at D is east. That's why the position of the particle or the velocity of the particle is continuously changes. Which velocity? Only direction of the velocity. Listen very carefully. So when a body moves in a uniform circular path, speed is constant and direction of velocity is changes. Direction of velocity is changes. Direction is changes is nothing but velocity is also changes. Next, we discuss that here. So, when a body moves in the uniform circular path, we are discussing very clearly, speed is constant, direction of velocity is changes. Okay. But when the direction of velocity is changes, so in the 8th standard level, in the chapter of force, I clearly explained, or in the chapter of force, I clearly explained what are the changes can be produced by the force. Means one is there. The speed is changes by the force. The direction of a body is changes by applying the force. That's why that concept we can see here. So the direction of velocity of a body is changes. Means on that body, for changing the direction, some force is acting or not? Yes. Because of, we know that every body by itself it cannot be changed the direction. Must ensure some external force is needed. Okay. If you can consider a bus, the bus is in the motion. Okay. Without applying the any force on the steering, the direction of the bus is does not change. Is it correct or not? So when you are running, in case of human being or animal being, when you can change to turn our body, at that time only what will happen? Our body direction will be changes. So it's nothing but the direction of a body is changes is nothing but muscles or some force is acting on the body. Here is also, okay, just I will explain. Sun is there. Around the sun, Earth is revolving in a particular path or orbit, that is we know that. So now, with help of this concept, I will explain. In this one, we know that Earth is one of the planet in our solar system. Okay, the Earth is attracted by the sun like the another planets and revolving around the sun in a particular orbit. So that's why sun is the heavenly body and Earth is also heavenly body in the sky. That's why between these two, what is there? A force of attraction is there. Sun is having the gravitational force, Earth is also having the gravitational force. But now, first we discuss about the sun and Earth. Thus, Earth is attracted by the sun. Is it correct or not? With certain force of gravity. Okay, so that's why Earth is pulled by the sun with help of some force. That is, we know that. So now Earth is a point 8. What is the direction? North. If the Earth is comes to here, what is the direction? West. If the same Earth will become to here, what is the direction? South. If the Earth is here, what is the direction? Okay, east. So that's why here the direction of the Earth is gradually changes at every position. Means is nothing but the direction of the Earth is changes means what is the meaning? On the Earth, okay, some force is acting or not. Otherwise, Earth by itself, it does not change its direction. Muscles should on the Earth, some force will be acting. Which force? The sun. Attractional force is acting. This force is acting where? Towards the center. That's why, okay, when the planets are revolving around the sun in a particular orbit in a uniform circular motion, at that time the sun is attracts the or pulls the every body towards itself with a certain force. That force we are called gravitational force or centripetal force. Simply, centripetal force means simply I says that it is a force, it is always acting towards the center. That's why here the Earth is pulled by the Earth towards the center of the sun or not. That's why this force we are called as centripetal force. It's nothing but the Earth will be revolving around the sun. During such condition, to revolving the Earth around the sun, on the Earth some gravitational force of attraction is acting by the sun, that is in the form of centripetal force. Now, the centripetal force is always acting on the body, which direction? Towards the center. Is it correct or not? The direction of the body is moving into the, like this one, it is the velocity direction. It is the velocity. It is the velocity. But at every point, okay, you are observing that. So, it is the direction of the body, but it is pulled by this one. Again, the direction here. It is direction of the body, but it is pulled by towards the center. That's right. At every point, so the direction of a body is changes by acting some external force on it. That force is acting towards the center of the circle or towards the center of the object. That is we discuss in this time. So anyway, here, when a body is in the uniform motion, the magnitude of the speed is nothing but speed is constant. Velocity is changes. It's nothing but direction of velocity is changes. Direction of the velocity is changes is nothing but on the body some external force is acting. That's why only direction of the velocity is changes. Which force is acting? Centripetal force. That's why before the centripetal force, here we can find the, we can discuss the centripetal acceleration. Centripetal, why we discuss the centripetal acceleration means we know that acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. But here the body will be moved in a circular path, okay, with help of the centripetal force. That's why that acceleration is nothing but here the direction of the velocity changes or not. When a body is moving the uniform circular path, its direction is changes. Direction is changes is nothing but velocity is also change. The change in velocity is called acceleration. That's why when a body move in a uniform circular path, it will be how? Which acceleration? It has the centripetal acceleration. What is the centrifugal acceleration? I will explain. A of C. Centripetal acceleration is nothing but the acceleration which can change only the direction of velocity. Listen very carefully. The acceleration which can change only the direction of velocity of a body is called centripetal acceleration. Once again, listen. The acceleration which can change only the direction of velocity of a body is called centripetal acceleration. Is nothing but so velocity is changes, that is called acceleration. Why the velocity changes? By applying some force, external force. Anyway, the velocity changes, that change in velocity is called acceleration. If the velocity of a body is changes in the one dimensional motion, that is simply we are called acceleration. But if a body move in a uniform circular path, it help our, the velocity is changes by applying the centripetal force. That's why the acceleration produced in that body is by which force? Centripetal force. Due to that reason, we are called the acceleration is produced in that body by the centripetal force. That's why that is called centripetal acceleration. Listen very carefully. Change in velocity is called acceleration. But velocity is changes by applying which force here? When the in a uniform circular motion, centripetal force. That's why by acting the centripetal force on a particle when it is moving in the uniform circular path, its velocity is changes. That's why the acceleration we are called centripetal acceleration. Or one more thing, the acceleration produced in a particle or body by the centripetal force, that is called centripetal acceleration. But the major statement is the acceleration which can change only the direction of velocity of a body is called centripetal acceleration. Like this one, we have considered that. So in this one, just you can see, initially the particle or body is at point A. It will be moving in the anti-clockwise direction, again comes to the point A by passing through the B, C, D, A. That's why the body will be starting from point A, again come to the point A. That is, we say that it completed one rotation. So now we can say that in this time. In this one, velocity is equal to, we know that, displacement or distance traveled. That is concept we can say that. Main one. Actually, velocity is nothing but here speed. So 2 pi r upon t from Roman revolution. Actually, velocity is nothing but displacement by time. Displacement is nothing but the shorter distance. For one complete rotation, displacement is zero. That's why velocity is also zero. When you are concerned with magnitude only, at that time, the body will be started from point A, again come to the point B. Because of here, only the direction changes, but not the magnitude. That's why you can say the magnitude. So when the body is started from point A, again come to the point A, it will be complete one rotation. At that time, speed is equals to distance covered by the body by time. What is the distance covered by the body from A to A? It is nothing but circumference of circle. Its radius is R, we can say that. What is the formula of circumference of circle? 2 pi r. That's why the distance covered by the body is 2 pi r, the magnitude, and the time is, we don't know, that's why t. So velocity is equal to 2 circumference of the circle upon time, 2 pi r by t. From this one, t is equal to, we can write 2 pi r by v. Now come to another mode, this one, after this one. The sum of the magnitude of the velocity, sorry, the sum of the change in the direction of the velocity by the which one? Acceleration is nothing but by acting the force only. Listen very carefully in this one. Okay. So acceleration is equals to, we can write simply 2 pi b by t. In case of normal acceleration, velocity by time. But here the acceleration is changes from A to A, means the body will be revolved how much one? 2 pi, it means in 360 degrees. Is it correct or not? 2 pi into b by t, simply I have taken that. So the acceleration is nothing but the body start from point A to again point A. That's why generally acceleration is equal to velocity by time. But the velocity of your body changes with the time t, for which one? Incomplete one thing. That's why the body will travel how much one? 2 pi. Means 360 degrees total it will be revolving. Then 2 pi b by t. So A of c is equal to 2 pi b upon t, means we know that 2 pi r by b. That's why 2 pi r upon b, it is brings to the numerator side. A of c is equals to 2 pi v into v upon 2 pi r. 2 pi get cancelled. That is equals to v into v, v square upon r. So that, okay, centripetal acceleration A of c is equals to v square upon r, either small r or capital r. This is the formula to find the centripetal acceleration. So we know that when a body move in a uniform circular path, speed is constant but velocity is changes. Velocity is changes is nothing but not the magnitude, only the direction. If magnitude is changes, speed is also changes. But here magnitude is constant but direction only changes. But anyway, velocity is a vector quantity. That's why either magnitude or direction is changes. Finally, we discussed velocity is changes. But when a body moves in the uniform circular path, direction of the velocity is changes by acting some external force, that is the centripetal force. So by acting the centripetal force on the body, its direction is gradually changes. So finally, velocity is changes. The change in velocity is called acceleration. But the acceleration produced in the body by changing the direction of the velocity by the with help of which one? Centripetal force. That's why that acceleration produced in the uniform circular path of a body, that acceleration we are called centripetal acceleration. But how we can define the acceleration which can change only the direction of velocity, that acceleration we are called centripetal acceleration. But A of c, centripetal acceleration is equals to 2 pi by b, 2 pi b by t. Why? Because of means. So for one complete circular path, acceleration is equals to v by t, and that magnitude is equals to 2 pi into v by t. 2 pi means total will be revolving 360 degrees. Next, A of c equals to 2 pi r by v. 2 pi r by v means we know that velocity is equals to, based on the magnitude concept here. So 2 pi r by t means the distance traveled by the body from A to A for one complete rotation, it is equals to circumferency of circle, that is 2 pi r upon t. Then t equals 2 pi r by v. This value substitute here, then 2 pi r by v is brings to the numerator side, it will becomes to reciprocal 2 pi v into v by 2 pi r. 2 pi r, sorry, 2 pi, 2 pi get cancelled. V into v, v square upon r. That's why centripetal acceleration formula is v square upon r. So in our next coming videos, we discuss that what is the centripetal force and what is the centrifugal force, how the earth is pulled by the gravitational force, sorry, how the earth is continuously revolving around the sun in a particular orbit, not only the earth, remaining other planets, even though the sun's gravitational force is acting toward the center of the sun. For that one, we discuss the two concepts are there, centripetal force and the centrifugal force. What is the centripetal and centrifugal force? What is the relation? What is the difference between them? That is, we discussed in the tomorrow next video. Thank you.